this video is going to cover managing and uploading files into your media library. The types of files you can upload include images, documents, articles, and videos that are connected to YouTube or Vimeo. You can access the media library through the navigation bar. Here, you'll see your media storage along the bottom left. And to quickly search for any file in your media library, use the quick search bar to pull up that media file. Files are stored within folders in your media library. Start by creating a new folder and give your folder a descriptive name. Once you click to create, this will now add the folder to the list along the left. You can manage the file name by hovering over the file name and clicking the pencil icon. Here you can update the name or delete the folder from your account. Now that you've created a folder, you can upload files into your media library using the quick add button along the bottom right. Simply drag and drop files from your desktop to upload them into your media library. You can resize these files for the web, manage the contact access, which is group members, make it public, or shared with all groups within your account. If these files are associated with a specific event, you can specify that here. When you're ready, continue to upload the files. Once the files are uploaded, they'll be shown here in the media library. You can click on any of the files to bring up a preview along the right. Here you'll see a direct link to your media file, which you can use throughout the account to link to this image. To manage this file, click on Edit. Within the Edit screen, you can update the description of the file, identify the different group, as well as create a custom URL for this image or file in your account. If you're already using this file in any of your content, it's a good idea to replace this media file instead of updating all links throughout your CRM. Next, you can also modify this image. On the Modify Image page, you can adjust the height and width of this image, as well as add any text if images are not available for your contacts. You can crop the image, as well as use any other draw and effects to customize your image in the account. Next, you can save this as a new image in your account, or update the current image. By selecting multiple files in your media library, you'll see the preview along the right. Hover over the file to remove it from the selected list. From here, you can make a copy of these images, edit the files, delete them, or move them into a different folder in your account. The media library also allows you to create and store documents right from this page as well. To create a new document, click on the Document button along the top right. Here, you'll specify the document name, as well as identify the group you would like to associate it with. Check the boxes to allow group members access to these documents, as well as share them with all groups. Here, we left the public access blank, as documents are usually shared amongst one or two specific people in your account. Once you've added your document content, you can also add signature placeholders. This type of signature placeholders you can embed include recipient or sender initials, as well as full signatures for the recipient and sender. These placeholders populate when you send the document to your contact. Once both parties have signed the document, it becomes a PDF and is attached to that contact's record. Any document that is connected to a contact or sent for review is stored within the Media Library Documents area. Here, you can see their email, company, type of file, and document description. You can also track where in the document signing process this contact is. To view the document inside the contact record, click on the contact name. This pulls up the Contact CRM Activities tab and shows all documents associated with this contact along the right. Here, you can add a new document for the contact. First, identify the document name and load the template. Make any adjustments to the template before saving and sending it to the contact for review. This document will now show on the main documents area within the media library. The next option we have is the video. The video feature relies on the ID campaigns from your YouTube or your Vimeo accounts. Paste the Vimeo ID within the option and add a brief description for the video included. If a preview is available, the thumbnail will be displayed along the left side of this page. You can use this thumbnail as an image for clients to click on to view the actual video within your Vimeo or YouTube accounts. Specify the access level for this video and save the video to add it to the media library. Next, you can also create articles. Start by clicking on the Articles button along the top right. Similar setup to the document signing, as you would add the description, specify the group name and access level. Then you'll create the article content along the left side. Articles are a great way to share knowledge with your clients, so you can use our toolbox to add merges, widgets, wikis, additional articles, as well as pictures into this segment. Save the article here to add it to the media library. The final option along the top right is to upload files. This is the same as the quick add, where you drag and drop any files from your desktop to upload into the media library. All of the files we've created and stored in the media library can be accessed within the specific folder we created. You can organize and order this folder by the category, when it was created, or the description of the file. You can also mass check all the options here. A great way to send and track bigger documents to clients would be to first upload them into the media library. Each file comes with a custom link as well as a public download link for the client to export it onto their computer. Within the edit file page, you can add a password protection behind the file to prevent any unnecessary downloads of your documents. You can update the custom URL for the document here as well. The document download link is tracked, which allows you to activate a specific workflow to happen once the client has downloaded the document on their end. Your public asset library is a collection of PDFs from your media library that you can host on your website for public consumption. Within the Media Library dropdown, select Asset Library. This page shows a list of all the available PDFs in your media library along the left side. Start by identifying which library you want to edit, or create a new asset library here. Then add customizations such as the library name, font, color, and language preferences. If you are requesting an email when the PDF is downloaded, you can send the contact an email, send them to a custom thank you URL, and add them into a specific group within your account. Below the Update Settings button, you'll see the iframe embedding code, which you'll use to add this asset library into your website seamlessly. Within your library, you can create unique tabs to house the collections of your PDFs. Then simply drag and drop the PDFs along the left into your library for organization. You can customize this PDF view by clicking on the pencil icon. Here you can adjust the preview as well as assign a workflow when this PDF is downloaded. You can select a background color or use an image stored within your media library. Customize the thumbnail of your PDF by adding a title and subtitle as well as descriptions about the PDF. Once you save, you can also preview any of the PDFs within your asset library. You can download and print the PDF, as well as move to the next PDF in your asset library. The asset library is a great way to share PDFs from your system on your public website and use tracking and automation to add new contacts into your CRM.